Good morning, dear students. Today we are continuing with the exercise 13C. Already we have started this exercise in previous session. So let us begin with the question number 11. Okay, we are solving with the question number 11. The question is 25 2x plus y the whole square minus 16 x minus y the whole square. Okay, so students, now we have to apply the identity that we have learned in the previous session. So here we have to learn this property, identity that we have learned in the previous session. The identity was, if you remember, a square minus b square equals to a plus b, a minus b. This was the identity that we have learned in the previous session. Here also we are going to apply the same identity. Okay. Now, 25 is a square of 5. So, we can also write it in this way. The complete square. Understood? Similarly, 16 is a square of 4. So the same brackets can be written as in this way. So take this 4, means this square is common for 4 and also for the bracket. Also this square is common for 5 and for the bracket, because 25 is a square of 5. Now this complete bracket, square bracket, is considered as A and this is B. As per our identity, we will write A plus B means 5, 2x plus 1 plus 4x minus y. Understood? A plus B. In the next, we will write A minus B. A minus B. That means 5, 2x plus y minus 4x minus y. Okay. A plus B and A minus B. Now let us simplify these brackets. 5 2s are, it becomes 10x. 5 plus y will become 5y. 4 into x, 4x, and 4 into y is minus 4y. Got it? Similarly here, 5 into 2, it is 10x. 5 into y, it is 5y. Minus 4 into y, minus 4x, minus minus will become plus 4y. Okay. Now, the like terms. We can make an addition and subtraction of the like terms. So, 10x plus 4x will give us 14x. Plus 5y minus 4y will give us plus y. Means it is 14x plus y. Similarly, in the next bracket, there is 10x minus 4x will be 6x, right? And 5y plus 4y will be 9y. Okay. Now 14x and plus y will remain same. But here it is 6 and 9. Again, we can take out 3 common from 6 and 9. Okay. So that common 3 we can write here. 14x plus y. And from this bracket, we have taken 3 common. So it becomes 3 2s are 6, hence we can write 2x. 3 3s are 9, so we have written here 3y. So it will be the final answer. we have taken 3 common from this bracket, so this common 3 is written at the first step. Is that clear to everyone? Okay, so I hope all of you have understood this thing. Now, let us solve the next question. That is, question number 13. We are solving the question number 13. Question number 13 we are solving. It is like this. 6 fraction 2 by 3 the whole square minus 2 fraction 1 by 3 the whole square. Okay. Now what we will do? Simplify this. 6 threes are 18. 18 plus 2 will become 20 upon 3 the whole square. Minus 2 threes are 6. 6 plus 1 will become 7 upon 3 the whole square. Okay, so let us consider the first number as a, second number as b. So it is in the form of a square minus b square. So a square minus b square can be written as a plus b, first number plus second number. Similarly, it is a minus b, correct? 20 plus 7 will become 27 upon 3 and 20 minus 7 will become 13 upon 3. Right? Now let us make a cancellation here. 3 ones are 3. 3 nines are 27. Again, 3 ones are 3. 3 threes are 9. So remaining is 3 multiplied by 13. And 3 multiplied by 13 will gives us 39. Okay. So 39 is our final answer. Next we are solving is the question number 16. Okay. So it is 4.5 square minus 1.5 square. So once again it is a square minus b square. Okay. So, a square minus b square will become a plus b, and a minus b. Okay. So, addition of these two values, 4.5 plus 1.5 means 6. And addition of, subtraction of these two is 3. And the finally, we can write 6 is a 18. Okay. So students, write it in your notebooks. Writing is very important. Now the next question that we are solving is question number 17. Question number 17 we are solving. It is 75 x plus y the whole square minus 48 x minus y the whole square. Okay. Now students, if we observe this expression, to apply the identity we want whole square. But we observe 75 and 48. These two numbers are not a perfect square. Okay. So we have to think accordingly that if we want to apply the identity, that means we have to use or we can take out the common 75 and 48. These both numbers are multiples of 3. Right. So if we take this three common, we can write 25 and x plus y the whole square minus 48. 3 is common from the 48. So we can write here 16. 16 threes are 48. Understood? Now 25 is a perfect square. Also this 16 is a perfect square. Correct? So further we can write it in this way. 5 x plus y the whole square. Understood? And similarly here, minus 16 means it is a 4 square. So it will be like this. Now it is a complete square. So this whole term is considered as A. Means this curly bracket is considered as A. And this is considered as B. Okay. So A plus B and A minus B we are going to write here. Now it becomes 3. A plus B. That is 5 x plus y plus 4 x minus y. It is A plus B. And in the next bracket we can write 5 x plus y minus 4 x minus y. It is A minus B. Okay. Now let us open this brackets. So it becomes 5 into x 5x, 5 into y 5y, 4 into x 4x, 4 into y is 4y. And similarly here we can write 5x plus 5y. When we multiply the bracket with minus 4, it becomes minus 4x and plus 4y. Minus minus will become plus. Now let us make a addition and subtraction of the like terms. 5x plus 4x is the 9x. 5y minus 4y is y. 5x minus 4x, x. 5y plus 4y is 9y. Got it? So this will be the final answer for this question. Now the next question that we are solving is question number 18. Question number 18 we are solving. It is a square plus 4a plus 4 minus b square. Okay. So if we think about the first three terms, these are our first three terms. It is a complete square of a plus 2. Okay. And minus b square will remain same. Okay. It is in the format of a square plus 2ab plus b square. A square plus 2ab plus b square can be written as a plus b whole square. Already we have done it in the previous session. What we have to do? A is a square of a. Take the sign of middle term. Eliminate the middle term. And 4 is a perfect square of 2. So we can write a plus 2 the whole square. Now this complete bracket is our a. Means it is a square minus b square. So we can write a plus b and a minus b. This is the final answer for 18th question. A means first bracket plus b minus b. Got it? Then we are solving the question number 19. A square minus b square minus 2b and minus 1. Now, from the last three terms, if we observe the last three terms, again it is a complete square like this. But it is not in a proper order To make it as a proper order, let us take minus sign common. So whenever we take the minus sign common, we need to change all the signs. So this minus will become plus v squared. Again this minus will become plus. Again this minus will become plus, like this. So we can write it in this way. A square minus, it is a complete square of b plus 1 whole square. Got it? A square plus 2ab plus b square. So it becomes b plus 1 the whole square. B is a square of b. Take the middle term sign and plus 1. 1 is a perfect square of 1. Now apply this identity. A square minus b square. Now it becomes a plus b and a minus b. We applied the identity. So it becomes a plus b plus 1. And this will become a minus b minus 1. Okay. When we open this bracket, both of the signs we need to change. Is that clear? Then we are solving the question number 20th also. For this 20th question, x square plus 6x plus 9 minus 4y square. As we can see, the first three terms are the perfect square of x plus 3, and 4y square is a complete square of 2y. Okay, now it becomes a plus b, a minus b. So we can write it in this way. X plus 3 plus 2y and x plus 3 minus 2y. Okay. So this is the final answer for the question number 20. Okay. So students, now we will stop here for this session. We have completed the exercise 13C. Tomorrow we are going to start with the new exercise, that is 13D. Bye bye everyone. Good day. Take care.